Hi everyone, how you doing? How's it going? We say these things to one another, don't we? How's your day going? And it reminds me, I don't know if you remember it, that clip on off Fawlty Towers when Lord Morbury's about to leave and Basil says to him, "Well, how are you, Lord Morbury? How are you then? All right, mate. How's me old mucky?" So why do we say these things to one another? Well, it's probably because nearly all of us base our feelings on our present circumstances. If we're having a good day, we'll be feeling good about things, good about ourselves. And that picture that we have in our mind of whether things are either looking up or going downhill will have a great bearing on how we feel. So then, that question that we ask each other is really this: are you feeling hopeful or hopeless today? Are you walking in hope? Now, there's things that make us more hopeful, and it's endless. Things like our car's just passed its MOT. The recent blood test results have come back okay. Might have lost a bit of weight, or Nottingham Forest have signed a new player that looks pretty good. It could be one of a thousand things that make us feel more positive and more hopeful. We might have had a second vaccine and feel confident that we will survive the pandemic. COVID cases might be coming down. Whatever it is, if we are feeling hopeful, we can reply to that question, "How are you?" We can reply, "Top of the morning," or "Never been better." But there's a reverse side of all this, things that make us feel hopeless. We might have noticed a dodgy looking lump somewhere on our body, or says something wrong at work that we are worried about. It can be one of thousands of things. COVID cases might be going up. One of our family is unwell. And that can all determine how we feel about things. And if we are feeling hopeless, we might reply to that question, "I've been better," or "I've been worse." And most of us only go on at that generally totally inaccurate picture that we have in our minds of how things are going. It's a cloudy and blurred understanding that we have of our present situation, and it's completely false. And it has little value owing to the fact that we don't know what will happen tomorrow. So, our car is past its MOT, but it might break down tomorrow. The blood test was okay, but I might get hit by a bus tomorrow. COVID cases have gone down, but a new variant might emerge. On the other side of the coin, the dodgy lump that we noticed is harmless. The wrong thing that we said at work went unnoticed. COVID cases may have peaked and go down again. It can all change tomorrow, for better or for worse. We don't know. But one thing that we do know is that God knows the future, and we can trust Him with it. And as God's people, we have hope. We are called to hope. The Apostle Paul admonishes us to rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Now, when life's good, it's easy to be hopeful. We feel thankful for the beauty of each day, and we give thanks for the splendour of autumn and for the crispness in the air. We're even thankful for cold mornings, the warmth of the sun at noon, and for the brightness of the moon at night. However, when life is cruel and difficult, when life seems miserable, hopefulness is something that comes hard. Autumn appears drab. Cold mornings only symbolise the challenges of life. The sun has an annoying glare, and the moon seems irrelevant. And things that we'd often enjoy, like football or sport, become pointless. Nice meals and a good film seem petty when life is difficult. So how in the world are we ever to do the will of God by rejoicing always and giving thanks in all circumstances? In Philippians chapter 1, we read how Paul himself did it during his imprisonment. Alone in a dark, dank cell, with being beheaded as his apparent destiny, Paul rejoiced. But it's worth noting that Paul didn't rejoice or give thanks for being restrained in a prison. He didn't give thanks for the morning or the air that he breathed. Paul did not thank God for the sun, the moon, or the stars. Paul gave thanks and rejoiced in the only thing that he had left in that dark, clammy jail cell. Paul gave thanks and rejoiced for hope. Paul hoped that the gospel would be spread with even greater boldness because of his imprisonment. And Paul hoped that through prayers the Spirit of Jesus Christ would work out all things for good. Paul hoped that God would wring whatever good could be wrung out of this, his most difficult hour. Hope was the only thing that Paul had left, and hope was enough. Hope was all that Paul needed to give thanks and to rejoice in his miserable circumstances. And the good news is, for persons with faith in Jesus Christ, who offers us a living hope, who promises to always be with us, for our deliverance, whatever our circumstances may be, Jesus promises us a new life, even when our old lives end. Hope is ours. Now, we may not be experiencing happiness at the moment, or put together a long list of things that we're thankful for, but on the list of every believer, even if there is only one thing on that list, there is hope. And life can take away much and destroy much in our lives, but there is one thing that we can always have that can't be taken away, and that is hope. So rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. And let us avoid allowing our present circumstances to influence how hopeful we are. Our hope is in Christ, in the unchanging and eternal promises of God. Hope for today and bright hope for tomorrow.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still and striving cease. My comforter, my all and all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Thank you. Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. And bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands at victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. In life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.